Today, let's talk about 10 different ways you can improve your productivity when you're using Microsoft Teams. If you have tips of your own, please share them in the comments below. Let's jump in. Tip number one, use shortcuts for faster navigation. To quickly search for something, use the shortcut key Ctrl+E. This takes you directly to the search bar, and then you can type in your phrase or your word and press enter, and it searches all your messages. You can restrict the type to just chat or channel, and if you have more filters you want to add to this, go to more filters. If it's a file you're looking for, switch your view to files. Now, if instead you're looking for something in a specific channel, use the shortcut key Ctrl+F. This restricts your view to that channel only. Then type in what you're looking for and press enter, and you get your results on the side here. Don't forget, you can also use commands in the search bar. So let's go back with Ctrl+E, press escape to reset this, slash, and then either select a command by moving with the arrow keys or just continue typing. In this case, let's say I want to switch my status to Do Not Disturb, so I'm going to go down to D&D, press Enter, and my status is updated. If you quickly want to jump to another team or channel, use the shortcut key Ctrl+G. This is going to bring up the complete list. Just select where you want to go to, press Enter, and you jump to that channel. To open a new chat window, use Ctrl+N. To quickly navigate to the different tabs you see on the side here, use Ctrl+1. This takes you to the Activity tab. Ctrl+2 takes you to Chat. Ctrl+3 to Teams and your channels. Ctrl+4 to your calendar. Ctrl+5 to Calls. And Ctrl+6 to Files. If you're in a meeting, you can use the shortcut key Ctrl+Shift+M to mute and unmute, and Ctrl+Shift+O to activate and deactivate your video. Tip number two, drag and drop Outlook attachments. You don't need to download an attachment to your computer and then upload it into Teams. You can just drag and drop it in a conversation or your chat. Here I'm in a channel. I'm going to click on New Conversation, and I'd like to upload a file that I have in my email. I just have to bring up the email, select the file, drag it, and drop it in here. Tip number three, share to Outlook. If you'd like to share a message as an email, you don't have to copy and paste it to your Outlook. Just go to More Options by clicking on the dots and select Share to Outlook. This is going to open up Outlook for you, and it's going to put the message with any links in there directly in the body of your message. You just have to type in the missing information, add anything extra you want to this message, and then click on Send. Tip number four, use Power Automate. You can use Power Automate directly from Teams to create automations between your applications. So in this case, we're going to add an automation that allows us to quickly create a card in Planner from any message that we select here. First, let's add the Power Automate tab. Go to More Apps and search for Power Automate. Let's add this. This is going to take us to the Power Automate page, and it's going to show us all the flows that we currently have running. So this is the same view that you see if you go to Office 365 homepage and you log in from the browser. One difference is that our view is restricted to Microsoft Teams flows, but we can change this and take a look at all flows as well. To create a new flow, select New Flow. This is going to take us to the Create tab. Here we can either create a flow from scratch or we can search for a template. Because my template involves Planner, I'm just going to type it in, press Enter, and I can see there is a template for creating a task from a message. That's the one I want, so let's select it. Next, I have to give this flow a name. I'll call mine Add Task to Project. Now, this flow involves Teams and Planners. We need to be authenticated. In this case, I have done that. So let's go with Continue. Next, I get to select the Planner group ID. The Planner I want to use in this automation is Finance, and the Planner ID is the Finance System Update. Now let's go with Create Flow. This is going to set up the whole template for us. It tells me your flow is already created, and let's click on Done. When I go back to home, I should see it here. Now, all of this is set up for me, but if I want to edit it or to see what type of actions and triggers are involved, I'm just going to select it and then go to edit. Here I can see the trigger. It involves an adaptive card. This gives me the ability to add information for each task that I'm creating. So this is kind of like a dialog box that's going to pop up. It's going to allow me to add a title and a due date, and I can update this as I need. The next is the action of creating the task. I have the group ID and the plan ID here. The title is going to be taken directly from the dialog box, so from that adaptive card. If I want to add this message or this task to a specific bucket, I can select the bucket from here. And in addition to this, I have other options. Now you can add more actions that captures additional information for your task. In this case, I'm just going to go with the default here. But one thing I'm going to do is to remove this last step. This is going to add a message to chat informing me that the action was done. So let's just go to the more options here and delete the last step and save the flow. Everything is set up for us. So let's go ahead and test this. I'm going to go to Teams. Let's pick any message here. Under more actions, I now see add task to project. When I select this, I should get a card here. I can add a title, select my due date, and submit. Now this task is created in Planner. If I bring up Planner here, this is finance system update. I'm going to refresh this and I see a no bucket part here with the task I just added. Power Automate is a very powerful tool. If you want to get started, I have a more detailed video on this. Link to it is going to be in the description. Tip number 5, use tags to group people in a team. Let's say you want to send out a new message and you want to notify the IT people who are within this team. You don't have to @mention each single IT person. You can create a tag that groups the IT people together. This way, you can @mention the tag name to notify all the IT people. To use tags, go to the team you want to add the tags to and go to More Options and then Manage Tags. Now, you can only do this if you're a team owner. You can't do it if you're a member. You have to notify the owner to do this for you. Now, let's create a tag. Tag name is IT Squad, and then we can add the people. And then create. I have IT Squad set up here. Now when I want to send a message and directly notify the IT Squad, I just have to @mention the tag name. Tip number 6, get all your to-dos and projects in one place. At Excel Plus, we use Planner and recently I've started to use Microsoft To-Do. To be able to see all my tasks from these two separate apps in one place, I can go to More Options here and add tasks by Planner and To-Do. Now, if you don't see it on this list, just type in Planner and it's going to pop up, then select it. Now, on top, you're going to see your tasks from To-Do. You can add a new task directly from here, so you don't have to go to the To-Do app because everything is synced. And you also get to see all your shared plans from Planner directly in here as well. This shows us the list view, but we can easily switch to board view and update the cards as we need to. So this saves you from going to two separate apps to manage your tasks. To make this new tab stick, just right mouse click and pin it. Tip number 7, pop out apps and chat. When you're in a different view in Microsoft Teams, like for example here, I'm in Tasks by Planner and To-Do, and I'm working on this board here, when I get a message pop up here and I click on it, it takes me directly to that chat. So it takes me out of this view. If you want to keep a separate instance of your view, just pop out the app. Right mouse click on the app and select Pop Out App. This will open a separate window for you so you can work in this view without being interrupted. In addition to popping out apps, you can also pop out chat. So here I'm in a private chat. I'm going to pop this out because let's say we want to work together on a file and we're going to have a lot of back and forth. I'm going to pop out the chat. This way I can put it to the side, or actually I can just snap it to the side and have my file on this side, so I can easily type in the chat and work on the file at the same time. Tip number 8, update your settings to improve your concentration. If you have messages constantly popping up on the side here, it's very distracting and it's difficult to get any work done. What you can do is update your availability status here. Change it to Do Not Disturb. This by default suppresses messages from popping up on the side here. What you can also do is set up a duration for your status. So go to Duration, under Status, you can change this to Do Not Disturb and set a duration for this status. You can set it to 1 hour, 30 minutes, and so on, or you can select a custom duration and click on Done. If you want to change your status back before it's due, just go back and either reset it or change it right here. Another option you have is to suppress the message preview. Go to your profile, settings, under notifications, turn off show message preview. This way, when you get a new message, you can see from who it was, but you can't see the content of the message. You have to click on it or go to chat directly to be able to see it. Number 9, use polls in Teams. To quickly add a poll to your conversation, select New Conversation, go to the Additional Options here, and click on Forms. Here you get to type in your question, add the different options. I'm going to add one more. You can activate multiple answers if you want. You also get to decide if you want to share the results automatically after voting so everyone can see, or keep the responses anonymous. I'm just going to leave it as is here and click on Save. That's the preview. It looks good. Let's send this. This way people can see the results are not anonymous and they're going to be shared here. They can vote. So I'm going to submit my vote here. And we get to see the responses on the bottom here. And finally, tip number 10, add your apps to Teams. If you and your team find yourself using apps outside of Teams, try adding them as a separate tab in your team channel. So for example, this channel here has files, which is there by default. There is Vicky, and it has two more apps that were added. It's the whiteboard app and the planner app. This saves us from logging into different applications. We have everything available directly in Teams. To add a new tab, just go to the plus here and search for your app. Now, this is not just Microsoft apps. You have a lot of different third-party apps here. So just search for it and add it here. And also, if you have some files that you need to add as a separate tab, you can do that. Just go to the file that you want, go to More Options here, and make it a tab. This makes it available for everyone in the team. So these were my 10 Teams productivity tips. If you have a favorite tip, please share it in the comments. In case you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up. And if you find yourself learning something new here and improving your skills, consider subscribing. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.